Day 5, surgical mask, trial 1.
Duke University researchers tested a variety of masks using a laser to show the disease particles spread by people even during normal conversation.
And you see these flashes of light. So by counting these flashes, we can get an idea of how many droplets you emit as a function of time.
We wanted to know which masks you probably shouldn't buy.
If it is a one-layer spandex, polyester stretchy fabric that you can breathe easily through and blow out a candle through it, this is not going to be protecting very well.
Researchers tested 14 commonly available masks. As you might expect, thicker masks worked better.
The cotton mask, for example, we tested a range of cotton masks, just a couple we had, and they blocked about 80% of the droplets, which of course is perfectly fine for everyday use.
Researchers say one of the major findings of the study is that other than the single layer fabric gaiter, just about any mask is better than no mask. But the single layer fabric neck gaiter they tested proved surprisingly bad.
That specific mask, we actually saw what seemed to be an increase in the particle numbers.
The single layer of fabric emitted smaller particles, which stayed in the air longer, potentially spreading more coronavirus.
There are plenty of other gaiters out there. There are some that have thicker material. If you double them up, if you fold them over, you have more layers, or maybe you wear two of those gaiters.
Researchers say more extensive testing needs to be done. Terry Sater, WISN 12 News.
The Duke University research showed the professionally fit tested N95 mask performed the best, followed by a surgical mask and then a polypropylene cotton blend mask.